Hello friends, we are starting a new online course called Magento 2 Development Workshop. On this workshop you will have lots of video lessons, homework, exercises, theory and practice which you can apply in your day-to-day Magento 2 work. With this course we can learn lots of interesting information for backend and frontend development, such as Web API, unit tests, Magento 2 ORM, rendering system, UI components and so on. The online course is 24/7 access where you can work and learn on your own pace. Go check out magemastery.net to see the details about this workshop. I will leave the link in the description below. Many of you are aware that checkout is built and based on UI components. This UI components from one side is pretty complex, from another side they are flexible to work with. However, in order to understand UI components, you have to apply some practice. And the thing is that there are some default and out-of-box Magento 2 UI components, such as a UI form and UI listing. These are two main UI components that include other subcomponents, such as fields, select boxes, buttons, some field sets, and other parts. So you can build such complex things or elements as form. However, checkout is slightly different because it's built not on standard main components. Checkout is built on its own. And it means this, that in order to understand UI components, you may want and build checkout customizations. You may want to start not from a backend part or backend implementation of UI components, but particularly customizing checkout and trying to understand how it works. So in this tutorial, we are going to customize a checkout and we will build a new step for checkout. We are using Magento 2.3.5 and I am aware that there are lots of tutorials on how to add a step. There is even a DevDocs documentation that shows how to create a new step. However, I never use that tutorials because and information because from my opinion, they are lacking some details. That's why I decided to create this tutorial and show you how to properly build a checkout step. So in order to build a checkout step, let's first of all create a new module. So I'm going to build a new module in app code Pronko and I will call it checkout. And as always, two files that have to be placed into our module. It's called Pronko checkout and etc. module XML, where we will have our configuration. But for checkout, I'm going to add a sequence and we'll add a module called Magento checkout because we are going to use configuration and the sequence of this configuration loading is important for our implementation. I will clear step later, cache. So in order to build checkout, we need to understand few things. First of all, that checkout contains two primary extension points. First extension point is XML configuration, layout configuration that allows to render or to put a layout for your new step. And with this XML configuration, in most cases, we will need to provide a so-called layout processor class that will be responsible for providing more configuration information for our step. That's first part. And second part that we are not going to cover, it's providing configuration values for such things as payment integrations or shipping integrations, or any additional implementations that require configuration that can be rendered and loaded directly into our UI components. This configuration is done via a separate so-called config provider class, also can be declared as part of our extension, and it can return configuration required for our components. Since we are not going to provide any custom or any additional configuration, it would be enough for us for building a new step to focus on layout processor class. And once these two parts are ready, what else we have to build is a view part or UI component that contains from a with a JavaScript file and HTML file. So let's go ahead and start building this functionality. And first file I will create, it's going to be a layout file under view frontend layout, and this is going to be checkout index.xml. The naming of this file is very important because if you will misspell it, you basically will not load the configuration on this page. If you would like to better understand how this works and what magic is applied to this layout file, feel free to check Mage Mastery online courses. On one of the courses, Magento 2 Development Workshop, we go deeply into Magento 2 routing, so you will better understand how it works. So for this checkout index file, what we would need to do, we have to open original file that is located under checkout module. So, and usually I copy this part. So instead of typing it, of course, there are plugins for PHP Storm or edit, maybe VS Code editor, in order to provide some templates, so you will not be copy pasting it or typing yourself. However, I prefer hardcore way typing it. For the reference block name, we are going to point to a name of a block, of a class, one page with the name of checkout route. So I can simply copy and paste this checkout route, so I can reference to this block and provide additional configuration. That's the whole point of Magento 2, that you're writing XML files and providing some configurations. That's why it's not a surprise that we're going to write lots of layout configuration or XML XML configuration. So once we are inside, we can add arguments, argument, JS layout, because as you can see, it's the only argument we provide. However, this includes lots of information that we are not really interested. So I will close types. We need components. We don't need, so as you can see, we have components. The main component is checkout. Then there are some children with its own UI components, subcomponents. And so we have errors, authentication, progress bar, estimation, steps. So we need steps, right? And as you can see, we have, and we aren't interested in a sidebar. So under steps, there are children, but before we will go to children, for steps, let's create the structure. So arguments, JS layout, XSI type array, then item components, and probably majority of these nodes exercise type is going to be array. Then we, I missed one. So components, checkout item children, exercise type array. Under children, we want to add steps, and here we will start adding our custom implementation. Again, item name children array. All right, so what we have? We have just layout components, checkout children, steps children. This is exactly the same structure. We just repeated it. Just layout components, checkout children, steps children. So once we did repeat this configuration, we can add, as we can see, we have two steps, shipping and billing. It's two out of box steps. And we are going to add third step. We can extend this configuration and add our own step. So let's have a look at shipping step. Shipping step is a UI component with sort order one, and it includes some additional children node with two things: step configuration for additional configuration, such as validating shipping rates, and shipping address. That also includes some config node, component. This is what we're going to create. Data provider, sort order within this children node, and children. And these children are additional UI components that allows us to extend shipping step. And I will just close all other shipping address field set. This is where we put under children, where we put configuration related to fields that we are going to render. But this is kind of a layout for shipping step, which we are going to slightly repeat. So in order for us to register a step, we have to, here is a level where we add new step. So I'm going to add a contact step. This is going to be some sort of contact information. And inside, I will need to add component config. String, this is going to be a collection of UI components. That's why I use UI component. It's a collection. Sort order exercise type string one. So sort order one and children. And type is array. Inside children, we are going to have a contact node. This is an array as well. And contact node contains a configuration. Plus, it contains other elements, and this is where we can add our link to our JavaScript component. So this is going to be a path to a JavaScript component. So Pronker checkout JS view, and name of a component or JS file is contact. So this component is responsible for rendering a part of configuration that is called contact. Item provider. This is a checkout provider. Item sort order. We don't really care about sort order, but let's provide it. Because we just only have one children or subnode. All right, let's move on in our super long configuration. Here we can start putting, we will add a children node, and inside this node we will put a field set. And this field set is going to be named as contact field set. Again, it's an array. And inside, this is going to be a collection component. That's why we will put a name UI component, so it can render a collection of items. Yeah, by the way, I forgot to add configuration. And this is a configuration that relates to level of provider, data provider that knows how and where it can get data from. So we are going to provide two nodes. First one is, this is a so-called path to our contact step dot contact step config. So it's contact step. And item name one, exercise type string checkout provider. And in order to reference to step config, we have to name it as checkout step. This is in case we will have step configuration somewhere here. And we can add this configuration into the list of dependencies, so it can know where to look for this configuration. But as of now, we don't provide this configuration. Let's leave it as is and we can even skip this step, this line. So let's continue building our super complex layout form. So this is a config. As usual, it's an array. And name depth, it's similar one what we've created. And we will put here a checkout provider. This is a place where we are going to get data from. Then display area item display area. Is going to be additional field sets and children exercise type array. Finally, here we can start adding our fields. So let's go ahead and create first name or declare first name as one of our fields. Usually here we have to provide configuration, full configuration for a field to be rendered. However, we are going to use layout processor that is going to be responsible for providing this configuration for every such field. Last name, sort order, 110, and phone, telephone. What did I miss? 120. All right, so this is how our configuration looks like in order for us to add, to declare as contact step and some configuration plus component, a provider where we're going to get data and some information. It's not full list of fields, I mean configuration for these fields, but some information about fields, how we can configure fields. The next step would be to create a block, but it's not actually a block, it's a layout processor. And this layout processor, as all layout processors, should implement layout processor interface with a single method process. So as you can see, we have argument JS layout. It will read and merge all the configuration from all such files and will put it as an associate array into as an argument of process method. And with this, we can start providing or modifying this JS layout before we will return it back. So what we are going to do? We are going to provide load information for attributes. Since we have first name, last name, and telephone, these attributes exist in customer address, and this is what we're going to load. But for this, we need to provide a dependency. I will tell you. Load attributes from the database. Then we have to get fields configuration for our step, and we have to merge attributes config and fields config. This is our scope for this layout processor. So in order to load attributes, we need attribute metadata data provider. This class is located in a customer module attribute metadata data provider in a customer module and is responsible for loading data. So here we are going to let's call it elements get address attributes private method that is going to be responsible for loading attributes. That's going to be an array. So here we are going to load our attributes using attribute metadata data provider and load attributes collection. We need to pass a name of an entity. Entity type is going to be customer address. There is a constant for this one, which we can use. And form code. In our case, it's customer register address that will have our attributes. So we will declare elements and we will go through attributes as attribute. We will read a code. But in order to see, you see, there is no help for when I type, so I need to provide a type. It's attribute interface. Yes, attribute interface. Next, I will use this attribute code as a key of an array, but there is additional class that we should also have. This class is called attribute mapper. It maps a configuration of a UI component for a particular attribute using it attribute type and returns this configuration. So for this we need attribute mapper class or object, so we can map our attribute. It will return configuration. And usually, if there is a label, and in our case it's going to be a label, this label is also used to be translated. But it's not a mandatory thing. Elements, code, label. Equals, and we are using this global function for translation. And finally, we can return our elements back. So this is how get address attributes method looks like. Let me import this dependency. All right, so we have elements. Then we need to have fields. And we're going to use a reference for an array so we can assign back to JS layout our modified fields configuration. So we're going to refer to components, checkout, children, steps, children. Here is the name of our step, contact step. Then again, children, about, I'm sure that there is a class which I'm not using for this implementation, but you can search and find yourself as a homework. So we got to fields. Now we have a variable that contains fields. What we have to do is, so basically we have fields and elements. We can use a so-called merger to merge our two configurations together. It's called merger. It's checkout related class. And here we can say that let's assign to our fields elements with the provider name checkout provider, with the name of a data scope prefix and fields. But the thing is, if we will open this merge, it will go through all elements and it will render these elements all together. But so it will contain more fields that we expect. So for this, what we can do, we can have array keys of fields. So in this case, we will have only three fields, and we can filter with the array filter our elements. Function key, and we are going to use fields quotes. And inside, we are going to return this element only in case a key of such element is in the list of field codes. But in order to have a key passed to array filter, we have to use a constant called array filter use key. So we will get three elements, and these three elements will be matched with three fields configuration. And in this way, we can get the right amount of attributes rendered on our page. The only missing piece here is construct and injecting our dependencies that we're going to do now. One dependency, attribute mapper dependency, and attribute merger dependency. Cool. Now we have a layout processor created. In order for this layout processor to be executed, we have to provide a configuration under frontend, and we have to create the XML file. In one of the previous videos, I created a directory and then file, and someone wrote in the comments that I can create in PHP Storm directories and files all together. So thank you very much for this valuable tip. Now I'm creating everything together and it does reduce time. So here we have a standard config root node where we have to provide a name of a block responsible for reading all these layout processors. And this block is one page. And it has an argument called layout processors. And here we can provide our layout processor with the type string. And let's put name of our layout processor. Cool. So it will read the configuration. It will read that we have a layout processor class declared, and it will pass JS layout into this process method. We will pre-populate data and configuration for JS layout with additional fields which we've loaded from a database, and we will return back for rendering. A rendering part has to be added under frontend web JS view contact JS. So this is going to be our contact element with or component. We have a reference here. So from this configuration, it will load contact, and we would need to create this step. Use strict. All right, so what dependencies we have? Magento UI JS form form. This is going to be our component. We have to return component and extend this component with our own configuration. We will have defaults, and in this defaults, we will have a template. And this is a reference to our template. Also, we need to have a quote model. Or not a quote, but step navigator. Usually all steps contain a quote model, and with this quote, depending on what's happening in the quote, we change a state of our step. So knockout dependency, and if we would need underscore. All right, step navigator is a must have because we have to register our step. Translation, mechanism knockout, and underscore. All right, so with each step, what we can have? We can have a visible parameter that is responsible for changing state of visibility. And we can use observable in order to update this update the template visibility. So initialize function, we are going to call super or parent, and here we are going to declare our step or register step. Register step should have a code of the step, an alias of a step. Alias cannot be empty because empty alias is already used by a shipping step. Visibility. Also, we are going to use underscore to bind to a navigate function and sort order that is also passed as part of our layout configuration. So let's quickly write a function for navigate step. Is visible true, but I believe that we can skip this navigate function, but it's required for registering a step. Also, we will create a function that is responsible for processing submit action. Here we can have validate form submission and so on, and then once success we can call step navigator next. All right. Here instead of observable we can use init observable function and use observe function in order to initialize it. Let's do this way. So we will remove dependency from a knockout and we will call init observable, and here this super and then observe and array of parameters we would like to observe. And as far as I remember, we have to return this. All right, so this is a JS part, and template part is going to be located in template contact dot html. All steps in the current checkout they are wrapped into a list element or li element. That's why we're going to have our main root element as li. So class checkout contact, this is for styling purposes. Data bind, here we are going to fade visible and we will refer to our visible parameter we've created. Class step title, we're going to use a built-in Magento feature called translate, and we will put contact. Data role title. Next one is div id, and this is going to be checkout step contact id sub element. And here we will also put a class step content and data role content. Inside we're going to have a form. Co-contact form. Class is form and methods form. Submit is also a feature. And here we will use our name of a function that is responsible for submitting this form. Set contact information. No validate, no validate. We are going to add div for contact form, and this div is responsible for field set, providing a template. Core for each, and we are going to use getRegion in order to render additional field sets. And here, for each such field set, we are going to, or UI component, we are going to render a template. And we will close knockout for each. And finally, actions toolbar, ID contact buttons container, class primary. OPC continue, type submit, and class, so this is button, action, continue, and primary. So we will style this button accordingly. And span, we are going to use translate. Next, or whatever we might want to use. So we have a contact template, contact JavaScript file that forms our UI component front-end part. For backend part, we have DIXML that registers our layout processor and layout processor that is responsible for providing configuration for our fields. So the only missing piece is to run setup upgrade. So our module will appear in the system. Also, I've made a typo that this class name should be not a string, but should be an object. So in this way, it will correctly prepare and load all layout processors. As we can see, our step is not loaded. That's the reason is because in order for checkout to render our step, we are missing this dependency or step configuration that also has to be added. So let's add this step configuration. Array, and this is going to be two elements, component, string, UI component, and item name children. This is contact validation.
array. So this is where we will add our validation. Inside this element. So let's clear cache and refresh a page. Now we have our step added. It goes before shipping because we provided sort order as one. And we have a field set with a step with a title contact and field set with three fields that can be provided and a button next. Obviously, when we click next, we don't have any front-end validation that has to happen here, as well as we don't send data to a backend. And this is probably going to be a good next tutorial on this channel. So let me know in the comments below what you think about checkout customizations. If you have any questions, maybe you would like me to continue this series of checkout implementation. And don't forget to subscribe, hit like button if you like this tutorial. I know this tutorial is very long, but probably if you watch up this end, like the whole hour, you probably really need to understand checkout. Checkout is very interesting and at the same time complex functionality, but it's good to know how to build something with Magento 2 checkout. Thank you for watching and I will see you in the next tutorial. Bye now.